Okay, now you can type your attendance.
Good morning, miss.
Good morning. Type your attendance. Okay. Okay, all of you take page number 34 of your textbook. That is not 34, 35. Did you read the poem? Did you read the poem once more? Yes. Okay. Now we want to discuss the activities of the lesson, isn't it? In the last class, we have discussed the meaning of the lesson, meaning of the song once more. Now we want to discuss the activities of the lesson. Okay. That is, first one, understand the poem. Understand the poem. Read these lines and answer the questions. First one, read these lines and answer the questions. Holding up a 10-brimmed cup full of summer's fragrance to the summer sun. Who is holding a 10-brimmed cup? These are lines taken from the poem song. Holding up a 10-brimmed cup full of summer's fragrance to the summer sun. Who is holding a 10-brimmed cup? Who is holding a 10-brimmed cup?
Flowers.
Yes, very good. Flowers holding a scent brimmed cup. Okay. Anne Marie, is it clear? Dia? Then next one. What does the poet mean by the phrase scent brimmed cup? What does the poet mean by the phrase "scent brimmed cup"? What does the poet mean? "Scent brimmed cup." By the phrase "scent brimmed cup," what does the poet mean? That means a cup filled up to the brim with the fragrance. That is flowers, isn't it? Scent brimmed cup means a cup filled to the brim with the fragrance. It is a metaphor for the flower. We can say it is a metaphor for the flower. Okay, here the poet describes about the flower. A flower is compared to a direct comparison to a scent brimmed cup. That means flower is filled with the fragrance. The sweet smell of the flower is described by the poet. By the phrase a scent brimmed cup, the poet means a cup filled to the brim with fragrance. A cup filled to the brim with fragrance. That is flower. Okay, I will give the answers. You just listen, okay? I think I want to give the answers for the lesson. This one. an interview with Milka Singh, isn't it? Did I give the notes? An interview with Milka Singh. I think we have completed the notes up to the story of Saptarishis, isn't it? Yes. I want to give the notes of an interview with Milka Singh. Okay. I will give it soon. Then next one. Is the answer is clear for you? Sun brimmed cup. Dia, is it clear? Next one, second one. Blossoms hold mines of gold deep within the farthest heart of each celestial flower. What does mines of gold refer to? What does mines of gold refer to? Mines of gold?
Honey?
Yes. Nectar, we can say nectar. Honey or nectar. Nectar that is present in the flower can be called mines of gold by the poet. Okay. Nectar that is present deep within the flower is called the mines of gold. Next one. What is each of the flower being compared to? What is each of the flowers being compared to? You will get the answers from these lines. Blossoms called mines of gold deep within the farthest heart of each chalice flower.
Chalice flowers.
No. What is each of the flower being compared? To what the flowers compared? Okay, Anne Maria?
Farthest heart.
No. A flower is compared to a gold mine. Okay, gold mine. Flower is compared to a gold mine by the poet. Okay, is it clear? Gold mine, a gold mine. Then, next one. Shall we move to the next one? Answer these questions. Yes. What wish does the poet express in the first stanza? What wish does the poet express in the first stanza?
To be a flower.
Yes. To be a flower. Then you can add more points. To be a flower which is nodding in the sun, then bending and up. Bringing in the breeze, then holding a flower which is holding a scent-brimmed cup. That means a flower which is filled with the fragrance. Okay, poet wished to be a flower nodding in the sun and bending and upspringing in the breeze and holding a scent-brimmed cup. Okay, is it clear?
Yes.
I will give the answers. Next one. What does the poet wish to do by becoming a cloud? What does the poet wish to do by becoming a cloud?
Blowing through the blue, shadowing the moon, rushing loudly through valleys deep, where torrents keep, always their plunging thunder and their misty arc of blue.
Yes, very good. The poet wished to be a cloud which is blowing through the blue sky, blue mid sky, and shadowing the mountains, yeah, and rushing, moving very fastly through the valleys. And this cloud made an arch of blue, that is, make an arch in the sky. Okay, these are the wishes by the poet, and these are the things which she do when she become a cloud. Okay, is it okay? Then next one. How does the poet describe the movement of waves on the sand? How does the poet describe the movement of waves on the sand?
Drawing back but leaving.
Yes. To be a wave splintering on the sand. That means this wave make fragments. Okay. Breaking into small fragments. This wave coming into the land and break that land into small fragments, and they lingered. They went, the wave went back and coming with speed and went back slowly. Okay, these are the movements by the wave. Then fourth one, according to the poet, how are waves different from flowers, insects and clouds? According to the poet, how are waves different from flowers, insects and clouds?
Bending the nerves, springing toes.
How are waves different from flowers, insects, and clouds? In the last stanza of the poem, we can see the answer. Difference between
only waves at play last forever, shall endeavor.
Yes.
Flowers will die, insects will die.
Yes. That is the correct answer. Flowers, insects, and clouds will end soon, isn't it? But in the case of waves, it lasts forever. Only waves at play last forever. That is the difference between waves and the flowers, insects, and clouds. Okay. Then next one, I think the answer is clear for you. Any doubt? No. Then Sean, why are you absent? Sorry, why are you late?
Miss, ivide net kittunnillayirunnu.
Okay. Then next one, think and answer. The poet in turn expresses her wish to be a flower, a butterfly, a cloud, and a wave. Which one of these would you like to be and why? Poet wishes to be a flower, butterfly, cloud, and wave. Which one you will choose? The question is, which one will you choose? Will you choose a flower, butterfly, cloud, or a wave? Anne Maria? Yeah. Okay, I will ask one by one again. Anne Maria, which will you choose? Flower, butterfly, cloud, wave.
Butterfly.
Okay. Butterfly. Okay, what is the reason?
Fly, always fly.
Yes, you can fly always. Very good, Anne Maria. Then Sean, which one will you choose? Flower, butterfly, cloud, wave. Which one will you choose? Which one?
Flower.
Flower. What's the reason?
It's very beautiful.
Yes, it is very beautiful. Any other reason? Okay, flower is very beautiful, so Sean wants to be a flower. Okay, then Dia, which one will you choose?
Cloud.
Cloud. What is the reason?
Always on the air.
Always on the
air.
Air. Okay, then very good, Dia. That's nice. Then Ijaz, what will you choose?
Wave.
Wave. What's the reason?
It is only for last hour.
Okay. Okay, I will choose flower. I also choose flower like Sean. Okay. Because it gave happiness to all, isn't it? Everyone enjoys the beauty of a flower. Even though it is a short living one, everyone likes a flower and everyone can enjoy the beauty of a flower. So I like to be a flower. Okay. You have your own ideas and opinions. Very good. Okay. I like your opinions. Then next one, what do you think the last two lines of the poem mean? What do you think the last two lines of the poem mean? These are the last two lines of the poem. Star and tower make a sea of purpose mightier than we dream today. What will these lines mean? Endeavor means sincere effort. We know that endeavor means sincere effort. Shall endeavor make a sea of purpose mightier than we dream today? It means we should make sincere effort to achieve our dream. Okay. We want to make hard work for achieving our goals. That is, we can say that the last two lines of the poem means that, okay, shall endeavor make a sea of purpose mightier than we dream today. We can achieve our goals, our powerful goals by sincere work or hard work. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes.
Then last activity of the lesson, know the poem, that is alliteration. Alliteration is the, did you know what is alliteration? Did you study alliteration? In your 7th standard? No. Alliteration? Okay. Now let's study about alliteration. Alliteration is also a poetic device. Did you know any other poetic device? I think we have studied some poetic device in your previous poem. No. Okay, I think it's understood. Poetic device. Have you heard about poetic device? No. Poetic devices are techniques used by poet in order to beautify their poem. Okay. Poetic devices are techniques used by poets in order to beautify their poem. Give more beauty to their poem. Some poets use some poetic devices. Okay. For example, we can see, we can say rhyming words. Rhyming words are some examples for poetic devices. That is, poet gives more beauty to the poem by the rhyming words. Okay. Like that, alliteration. Alliteration is a poetic device. Do you know simile? Have you heard about simile? Simile, metaphor, anything? No. No. In the last class you have studied, in 7th standard you have studied simile, metaphor. Okay. Okay. Now we can study alliteration. Alliteration is one of the poetic devices. Okay. You can see the definition of alliteration. It is very important. So you should underline that. Okay. Alliteration is the repetition of the same consonant sound at the beginning of two or more adjacent words. It is often used to make a poem rhythmic. It is also an effective tool to emphasize particular lines or ideas, making the poem not only more interesting but also easier to remember. Okay, here the poetic device alliteration is explained. Alliteration, you can study the definition of alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of initial consonant sounds in a line or in a phrase. Repetition of initial consonant sound. Initial means first. Okay, initial consonant sound. Do you know which are, how many vowels are in our English? Vowels, five. Which are the vowels?
A, E, I, O, U.
Yes, A, E, I, O, U. All the rest, A, E, I, O, U are the vowel sounds and the others are consonant sounds. Okay, vowels and consonants. Okay, here you should note that repetition of the initial consonant sounds, alliteration of is the repetition of the initial consonant sounds, not vowel sounds. Okay, summer, you can see an example. Summer sun, summer sun is an example for alliteration. That means you can see first, you should note the first word, summer. Summer begins with the letter S. And sun, yes, sun begins with the letter also S, isn't it? Here you can take it as the sound S. Sound S, not the word S, repetition of sound, initial consonant sound. You should note that alliteration is the repetition of initial consonant sounds, not vowel sounds, consonant sounds. Okay, in a phrase or in a line. Here you can see summer sun. Summer sun. One more example. Sally sells seashells by the seashore. Did you hear this phrase? Sally sells seashells by the seashore. Please write that in your notebook or textbook. Sally sells. Sally, S-A-L-L-Y. Sally sells sea shells by the seashore. This is just an example. You can write it on the side of your textbook. Okay? Okay, I will write this. Okay, please wait. Sally sells sea shells by the sea shore. Sally sells sea shells by the seashore. Okay, this is an example for alliteration. How can we say that this is an example for alliteration? Can anybody explain? Sally sells seashells by the seashore. How can we say?
All words begins with the.
Yes, all words begins with the consonant sound, not the word, consonant sound S. Okay, Z. Sally sells seashells by the seashore. Okay, this is an example for alliteration. Sally S. Okay, this sound is repeating. You should note that the sound should be in the initial or the first position. Okay, first position of the word. Okay, the consonant sound must be on the first position. Here S is in the first position, then here first, then here first, then here also first. Okay, this is in a single line. You should note that it should be in a single line. Okay, sometimes there will be a gap. Seashells by the seashore. Okay, by and the, but that is not a problem. This is repeated in the same line. Initial consonant sound is repeated in the same line. So we can say that this is an example for alliteration. Please mark this example for your easiness. Okay. Okay, is it okay? Is it okay? Okay, I'm going to end. Okay, here summer sun and bee a butterfly are two instances of alliteration from the poem. Instances means examples. Okay, instance means example. Summer sun, bee a butterfly are two examples from this poem for alliteration. Okay, now your activity is to find four more examples of alliteration from the poem and write them given below. Find four more examples. Okay, please find four examples for alliteration from this poem. You should note that repetition of initial consonant sounds, not vowel sounds. Okay, who will say the first example?
Coral caves.
Which one?
Coral caves.
Telling tales of coral caves. Yes, that's right answer. You can write telling tales of coral caves. Sorry, you should write telling tales. T-T. Telling tales. Only that, telling tales. T is the consonant sound there, okay? T, T. Then coral caves are also examples. Then next one, second one. You can see an example in the second stanza. Can you identify an example from the second stanza?
Winging with painted wings.
Yes, winging with its painted wings. Which is the consonant sound here? And Maria, which is the consonant sound?
Winging and wings.
Winging with W. In with, you can see W sound. W. Okay, winging with its painted wings. Okay, you can write it there. Winging with its painted wings. Okay. Did you write? Yes. Then next one. Next one. You can see in the third stanza of your poem an example for alliteration. Can you identify that?
Is blowing through the blue.
Yes, very good. Blowing through the blue. You can see the b sound. B. Blowing through the blue. blowing through the blue. Then Dia, can you say an example from the fourth stanza? Where is Dia? She had left it. Okay, then Ijaz.
Splintering on the sand.
Splintering on the sand. That is right. You can write splintering on the sand. Splintering on the sand. Okay. Splintering on the sand. You can write it there. Splintering on the sand. Did you write? Yes. Then can you identify one more example from the stanza? From the same stanza. Fourth stanza.
Telling tales.
Telling tales. We have already said that. Then. Yes, lingeringly the land, L sound, L. Lingeringly the land, L sound, L. Lingeringly the land. Okay. Right there, lingeringly the land. Is it clear? Any doubt regarding alliteration? Alliteration is a poetic device. Poetic device is used by the poet in order to beautify their poem. This use of poetic devices make the poem more rhythmic. Okay, here the alliteration makes the poem more rhythmic. Then we can say that alliteration is the repetition of initial consonant sounds in a line or in a phrase. Okay, initial consonant sounds. You should note the thing that it must be the initial consonant sound. Okay, initial means first letter of that word. Okay. Okay, Anne Maria, can you read all examples once more, one by one? All examples for alliteration.
Coral caves.
Yes, coral caves.
Ringing with its painted wings.
Okay.
Blowing to the blue.
Blowing to the blue.
Splintering on the sand.
Splintering on the sand.
Lingeringly the land.
Lingeringly the land. Okay. Okay, very good. These are the examples of alliterations. Is just anything else?
Telling tales also.
Yes, telling tales. Very good. These are examples of alliteration. Okay, I think you got an idea about what is an alliteration. Okay. In the next poem also, you want to study more poems, isn't it? So during that time, there will be activities related to this alliteration. You will ask to identify alliteration from the poem. So you should listen. You should learn carefully what is an alliteration. What is alliteration? Okay. Don't forget these type of things. These type of poetic devices are very important. First one is alliteration. Then you will study about metaphor, simile. These type of many poetic devices are there. So now you should study about alliteration. In your higher classes also, you want to study this type of alliteration, assonance, like that poetic devices. Okay. Very important. You should know that this is very important. Alliteration is very important. Okay. Okay, our lesson is over, and only 4 minutes are remaining, so we don't have time to start our new one. In the next period, we will have grammar session. Okay, we want to discuss some grammar questions. Next period. Then, now I think only 4 minutes. So, can anybody explain the poem in your own words? Stanza by stanza. Try to explain, okay? Ijaz, can you? First stanza of the poem. You can say it in your own words. In one or two sentences, okay?
Poet is wishing to be a flower.
Yes.
Nodding in the sun.
Yes.
Blooming and upspringing.
In the breeze.
In the breeze. And holding up a sun-brimmed cup with full of fragrance.
That means a sun-brimmed cup means?
Sun-brimmed cup, the flower.
Yes, flower is a sun-brimmed cup. That means the flower is filled with the?
Fragrance.
Yes, fragrance. Yes, very good. Sean, can you explain the second stanza?
Poet wish to a butterfly.
Yes.
Fill upon a flower. Winging with its painted wings.
That means? Winging means? Closing and opening its wings. Then? These butterflies are happy. Yes, they are happy in heaven.
Blooms for the minds of God.
Deep within the heart, farthest heart of each celestial flower is. This butterfly can suck the nectar. Minds of God means nectar. Okay. These butterflies can suck the nectar from the flower. Okay. See there? Next. Cloud. Third stanza, can you explain the third stanza? Try to explain the third stanza. I will also help you, okay?
Miss Mansi,
can you explain the third stanza of the poem? Or to be a cloud? Okay. Tell the poet.
How to be a cloud blowing through the blue forest nature.
Here the poet wishes to be what? Wishes to be a cloud. Okay. Yes. The poet wishes to be a cloud and the cloud is blowing. Blowing means moving. Blowing through the blue. Blue means?
Sky,
okay. The cloud is moving through the sky and shadowing the mountains. That means the cloud is moving through the mountains, moving through the blue, and rushing loudly through valleys. Yes, moving very fastly above the valleys, above the rivers. And this type of the poet wishes to be a cloud like this. Okay. Okay, our time is going to end. Now we can wind up our class. We can meet in next period. And we will have grammar session in that period. Okay? Bye. Thank you.